Hi there, Capricorn, and welcome back to Star-Lord is Tarot. This is your tarot forecast for the week of March the 22nd through to the 28th. I went ahead, shuffled the cards, laid them all out. Let's see what's going on for the Cappies. First up, we have the Queen of Wands in the upright position, followed then by the Page of Swords upright. Next, we have the Eight of Wands in the upright. Next, we have the King of Swords upright. And lastly, Major Arcana, the Hierophant in the upright position. All your cards are upright. What is going on here? Lots of things happening for Cappy. Could be like a week full of activity. The Queen of Wands comes up first for your overall energy. This could be someone external to you, or it could be you embodying the energies. The Queen of Wands is fire energy, that of Aries, Leo, Sag, Sun, Moon, or Rising, male or female. This could be somebody who's playing a pivotal role this week for you. This could be a go-getter. This could be somebody who's moving and shaking and getting things done, making things happen. This could be your boss. This could be your spouse. This could be a family member, could be a friend, could be just about anybody. It's just a general read, right? So could be you. Maybe this is someone in your workplace, perhaps, that sort of cracking the whip. This could be someone who's this could be your best friend who's sort of lighting a fire under you, telling you to go, this is the time to strike, get moving, Capricorn. Could be that kind of situation. This could be anybody, but whatever the situation is, there's a lot of movement connected to the Queen of Wands. This is about action, can sometimes represent travel. Maybe this is a travel agent for some of you, or this is someone arranging some kind of, well, that would be a travel agent, but this could be somebody arranging, like, as in, you know, family member, a friend, your partner, or something like that, arranging something. Coming right at the beginning of the week, we have the Knight, or not the Knight, I always say the Knight because of the Knave, but this is the Page of Swords in the upright position. The Page of Swords is another court card, could be representing a person. This time it's air energy, that of Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, Sun, Moon, or Rising, male or female. Could be some of you are getting some messages from a Page of Swords. This can sometimes represent a younger person or somebody who's not fully developed, like sort of immature in their communication styles. This could be somebody who's spreading some news, gossip. Sometimes this could be representative of someone looking into your affairs. Could be a little bit of a stalker energy, somebody checking out your social media, that kind of thing. But it could also be someone who is, doing a background check. If you're applying for a job, or if you're applying for an apartment or something like that, it's just somebody doing a background check. Others of you, this could be gossip at the water cooler, that's what I call it, where everybody gathers around the water cooler and they all have, some gossip to share. And sometimes this could be gossip, but you really need to look out with the Page of Swords, because they're sort of not fully, like, their information is not something that is guaranteed. I don't know how else to say it. I'm not saying the person is lying, because in the reverse, it could be somebody lying, but in the upright, this person's not lying, it's just they don't know the full story. So maybe there's a rumor going around at work, or maybe there's a rumor going around in your neighborhood or something like that, and in your family, and somebody's just sort of spreading some information. It could be true, could be not true, but this person isn't intending to mislead you. It's just the person maybe just doesn't know the full story here. It could just be messages or news that come in just a little bit, maybe to enough to sort of pique your interest. And it moves into full-blown communication because the Eight of Wands follows it. So even if at the beginning of the week, Capricorn, you're just getting little floods of information, it could just, open up the dam and tons of information now come in. The Eight of Wands can represent arrows of love, find their mark. So for some of you on the romantic front, maybe there is somebody messaging you. Could be a younger person, could be somebody who's just very immature in how they speak. Maybe they're just giving you back one word answers. Doesn't mean they're not interested. It just means they could be shy or whatever else is going on. But the Eight of Wands, there's lots of communication going on now. Back and forth. This could be good news if you are applying for a job. Maybe you're getting a lot of people, taking the bait, so to speak. This could be really good news if you're in business for yourself. It could indicate a lot of a lot of orders coming in. Good news for those in sales, could be a lot of sales. Others of you, this could be if you're on dating sites, perhaps you're getting a lot of communication there from someone. If you're newly dating someone, it could be that there's a lot of communication going back and forth. The arrows of love find their mark. Could be about news and communication about travel, because it's wands. So just again, take what resonates for you. This is a general read. It's meant for thousands of Capricorns. So just take what resonates. If it doesn't resonate for you, then check back next week. What can I tell you? Or you can check your, a lot of people don't know that, most of you, my wonderful viewers do know to check your moon, your rising, and Venus signs as well. Maybe get more of a story or a better storyline there. And moving on towards the weekend, we do have the King of Swords here in the upright position. The King of Swords, it's interesting because it goes from the Page of Swords at the beginning of the week. So someone else had a similar reading where the information goes from small information up to, you know, more intense information. So it looks like whatever is going on at the beginning of the week, the small amount of information you're getting towards the end of the week, you'll probably get the full story, because that's what the King of Swords does, gives you the full story. The whole story, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. Can sometimes, this is again, air energy, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, but this could represent a police officer, a surgeon. Maybe if you have to deal with any surgical procedures, this could be that you're talking to a surgeon at the end of the week. This could be representative of a military person, perhaps. Could be an arbitrator, could be a lawyer. Maybe you're dealing with a lawyer at the end of the week for some reason. Could be over contracts for some of you. But if this is just a person in your life, this could be somebody who all of a sudden they go from not speaking very much. Maybe they seem a little immature at the beginning of the week and then they show their maturity later on. If this is on, you know, a personal level or a romantic level, it could be things are different. But this is definitely good news if you're, you know, in an arbitration situation. Somebody could be speaking on your behalf, could be a lawyer contacting you about some news and information about progression and things that are happening behind the scenes. Could definitely be a lawyer, because the contract card is following it. This is Taurus energy, so some of you could be dealing with a Taurus. But this is the Hierophant in the upright position. Hierophant governs contracts and those things that are official. Could be signing on the dotted line, perhaps for a legal situation, perhaps for a home, perhaps I don't know. I know you need a lawyer for a house situation, but could be signing if you're committing to, like, say sometimes the Hierophant can be about being offered a term contract, right? Especially for something official like the government or something like that, a school. Maybe you're given a 6-month contract or a year contract, and this could be the lawyer, you know, in the contracts together. For others of you, this could be you're committing maybe to someone. Maybe you're having a full blown mature conversation with somebody and you're going to be committing to them. Now this could be on a business level or it could be on a personal level. Take what resonates. So that is your very interesting reading, Capricorn. I really hope it helped you. If it did, please feel free to like, share, and subscribe, and I will see you next week. Bye bye for now.